major impact is that it's allowed finance and financial products to reach into everybody's mobile phone. It's made access easier. It's made payment money much more easier. And going forward, it's a habit which has to take its own place to become cashless. And I work for the Indian Post Office, and we have recently launched our payments bank, which is a digital mobile-based accounting system in which ordinary people, the common man, who's not having any bank account, has now got a bank account. In the last 1 year, we've opened 1 crore and 5 lakh accounts in the country. And it's all due to the fantastic technology, which you don't have to invest in heavy assets, brick and mortar. And our postmen are opening accounts.
So as far as finance is concerned, I basically into the wealth management, what I can say, it's making huge difference, because till now wealth management was for very few people, because people to people interaction were there. But with the technology coming in, so it is reaching to the masses. So people started investing very small amounts, 500 rupees, 1000 rupees. So it's making huge difference. You can say it's an inclusion drive that is happening.
So I think now the expectations from the finance function is changing many folds. And the expectation is that, you know, how much more analytics and how much more deep-rooted, analysis, etc., you know, can be shared so that the right business decisions can be made. So what that really means is that the availability of data is not just limited to what's available within your own organization, but you are leveraging data which is outside your organization in a structured, unstructured format, leveraging technology to, you know, drive some of these, analytics and decisions, right? And the second one is the expectation definitely is for a leaner finance function, a more efficient, more cost-effective in performing their deliveries, etc. So some of these are the key changes, you know, that we're observing on the finance side.
Well, technology can, anybody with an internet can break into systems. Even the big defense sites are there. So it has to be protected. So the legal framework has been put in. We need to protect the customer's privacy. We need to have proper device integrity. We have to have cryptographics. That way, you have to protect the customer. So there is a possibility of frauds happening. Mobile wallets have been misused for money laundering purposes over the years. So there are checks and balances, and the algorithms are in place to monitor the financial habits of people, where they're sending money. You see, once you money changes hands through many accounts, it becomes from black to white. So it's very easy to launder money. So these things are being, actually we're doing a lot of training programs for our staff.
It's anybody's call, basically. We have seen technology playing a very bad part also. So, but the way safety has come into the system, the military level of security and other sort of securities, things are improving, OTPs and everything. So things are improving, but it will take time. It is dangerous, but we have to see the benefits. So benefits sometimes outweigh the losses and all these things. So I think with the time, it will improve.
It's very, very safe. And I think that's the change in technology, right? So one change in the technology versus the last couple of years is that firstly, you know, you can work on data which is both structured and unstructured, right? I mean, traditionally, you know, we've only worked on data which is in a structured format, etc. So that's one part of technology that is changing. Second part is, you know, where the ability of technology to analyze at supersonic speed with 100% accuracy, very, very large data, big data sets, and give accurate results, right? So that's the other part of technology, you know, which has changed. And the third part is that the technology is also learning, and which is where, you know, the concepts of machine learning or AI comes into place, because, you know, technology can be trained, you know, to be able to be as accurate as a human in a situation, and in many cases, more accurate than a human, right? So some of these are the factors which make me very confident that, you know, you can rely on technology.